Nama om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Paditanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadarha Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing the glories of the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
我们前几节课聆听到了主Krishna消时光的荣耀。
And Sukadeva Goswami points out that the pastimes of Lord Krishna are going on eternally in Braja Bhumi.
Sukadeva Goswami 指出, 主 Krishna 的消逝光, 永恒地在 Braja Bhumi 上演着。
Even after Krishna leaves Vrindavan to go to Mathura, the people in the ladies in Mathura, who are all great devotees, they understand that Krishna's pastimes are still going on in Vrindavan.
即便在主 Krishna 离开文达文去了马图热之后, 马图热的女士们, 她们都是主的伟大的奉献者, 她们也明白, 主 Krishna的消逝光仍然在文达文上演着。
They describe that the lotus feet of Krishna are worshipped by Lord Shiva and the goddess of fortune, Rama Devi. And Lord Krishna himself is engaged in wandering about in Vrindavan, performing his many pastimes. So there are many statements in the scriptures to support that Krishna's pastimes are going on eternally in Vrindavan. But not only do we have statements of the scriptures, there are many great devotees who have personal experience of Krishna's pastimes going on in Vrindavan. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes that the holy place of Mathura is very intimately connected with Lord Krishna. And the reason why it's so intimately connected is because Lord Krishna lives there eternally.
之所以马图拉跟主Krishna有着亲密的联系，是因为主Krishna永恒地居住在那里。So,
Lord Krishna, he influences Cupid. Cupid means the god of love. Lord Krishna influences the Cupid, the god of love, for both the women of Braja and the women of Mathura.
Krishna 影响了爱神丘比特，这对于 Vrindavan 的女人们、女子们以及 Mathura 的女子们都是同样适用的。
Mathura is actually a city. So when we say Mathura, we mean Mathura city.
Mathura 实际上是一座城市。当我们指 Mathura 的时候，就是特指 Mathura 这座城市。
But when we say the city, then we should understand that that means that when Krishna goes away to Mathura.
指马图尔这座城市的时候，就是指的当主 Krishna 离开去了马图尔之后。
And when Krishna goes to Mathura, then the gopis are in agony. They're in great pain due to the separation from him.
当主 Krishna 去了马图尔之后，那些 gopis 们由于跟主 Krishna 分离，就体验到了去。
And it's at that time the gopis get the highest, they experience the highest prema. Their love for Krishna is the greatest at that time.
在那时，他们对 Krishna 的爱达到了最高的顶峰， Krishna prema 的爱达到了巅峰。
And that's why Sukadeva Goswami, when he's talking about Krishna's pastimes,Then he talks about Krishna going to Mathura.
正是由于这个原因，当 Sukadeva Goswami 谈论 Krishna 的消时光的时候，他谈到了 Krishna 去 Mathura 的消时光。
Actually, Krishna is still in Gokula eternally. He lives in Gokula, but to increase the love of the gopis, Sukadeva Goswami talks about him going to Mathura.
实际上 ，Krishna 永恒的居住在 Goloka， 但是为了增加对 Gopi 们对他的热爱 ，Sukadeva Goswami 特地谈到了 Krishna 去 Mathura 的消时光。
So the super soul who resides in the hearts of all living beings, he took up a residence in the womb of Devaki.
居住在所有众生心中的超灵。就随后又居住在了 Devaki 的子宫当中。
So as the super soul, Krishna is passive. He's a passive supervisor, right? The super soul is the overseer, the permitter, described in Bhagavad Gita, Upadashyanamantam cha, right? Upadashtra. He's the supervisor.Krishna is the supervisor, but he's passive.
主 Krishna 作为超灵的形象，他是被动的，居住在众生的心中。他作为监督者，作为允许者，居住在众生的心中。这在《国家梵歌》当中有讲述。
But as the son of Devaki.Krishna speaks and he reciprocates with Devaki in many loving ways.
但是身为 Devaki 的儿子，他与 Devaki 交谈，并且跟他以爱心，跟他进行了许多爱心的交流。
And there are many great heroes in the Yadu dynasty.And they're all servants of Lord Krishna.
在亚度王朝当中，有许许多多伟大的英雄们，他们全都是 Krishna 的仆人。
And these heroes of the Yadu dynasty, they're able to defeat all the evil forces.
亚度王朝的这些伟大英雄们，能够击败许多的邪恶势力。
But still, Krishna likes to use his own two arms to kill the opposing kings.
So Krishna 仍然喜欢用他的双臂杀死那些邪恶的君王。
And Krishna also destroys the sins He destroys the sins and the miseries of all moving and non-moving creatures.
Krishna 也摧毁了移动和不移动的生物的许多的罪恶。
But when he's with the gopis, he acts in a different way.
但他跟gopi们在一起的时候是另外一种行为方式。
Although the gopis are married to other men, Krishna encourages them under the influence of Cupid.
尽管gopi们嫁给了其他的男子，to Krishna， 在丘比特爱神的影响下，却鼓励了他们。
And in this way, Krishna becomes their lover.
以这种方式，主Krishna成为了gopi们的爱人。
And by doing this, Krishna increases their shame and their misery.
以这种方式，主Krishna增加了gopi们的羞涩，增加了他们的苦恼。
So this is not a fault of the gopis, actually.
事实上。 这个对Gopi来说并不是错误。
Because it's just the beauty of Krishna's face that puts them into that situation.
因为Krishna面庞的美丽，就使他们处于这样的境地。
So in this way, Sukadeva Goswami presents the understanding of Lord Krishna's pastimes.
以这种方式, Sukadeva Goswami 就呈现了对主Krishna的逍遥时光的理解力。
And Sukadeva Goswami is proving, without any doubt, the supreme position of Lord Krishna.
Sukadeva Goswami 毫无疑问的 证明了主Krishna的超上的地位。
And his compassion, Krishna's compassion and Krishna's concern for his devotees.
以及主Krishna对他的奉献者们的怜悯和关心。
So now, Janmanjaya is speaking. Janmanjaya means he's the son of Maharaj Parikshit.
So,
Janmanjaya said, I am all successful. He said, I am all successful. He said, for you, O spiritual master, have given me the opportunity to relish the glories of Goloka. So Janmanjaya had been hearing from a great sage called Jaimini Rishi. And he had received everything he had asked for. He is fully satisfied. And he's so happy that he's convinced that he has achieved his goal. And he's very appreciative to his spiritual master, Jaimini, and he calls him Bhagavan, which means he sees him as being equal to God. And he's very grateful for the mercy Jaimini had shown him. So Jaimini replies to him and he says, "Yes, my dear boy, what you say is true." Anybody who hears or chants or meditates upon this pastime, this story with devotion will get to go back to Godhead.
任何人倘若他聆听、唱诵或者冥想这段叙述，怀着巨大的奉爱之情，都能达到至尊主的居所。So
Jaimini was very happy to hear the appreciation of his disciple. And he could see that the words which he was speaking were full of love of God. And from what Jaimini said, Jaimini could understand that his disciple had understood everything he had heard. So that's why Jaimini calls him my dear boy. He's very pleased with him.
因此，Jaimini称他为我亲爱的孩子，来表明他对他的满意之情。So
Janmanjaya was right to say that now his life was successful.
Janmanjaya称自己的生命大功告成了，这是完全正确的。
He had listened very carefully to Jaimini's words. And he heard everything about the glories of Goloka. And simply by hearing or chanting this story with devotion, then you can also go to the earth. Back to Godhead.
谁若是怀着奉爱之情，聆听或者唱诵了这段叙述，这段消时光，他也能够回到神手身边。Even
if what somebody's just thinking about it deeply, they can also go back to that. They'll go back to Goloka.
甚至一位深深的冥想这段消时光，这段叙述的人。
And if you do the regular practice which is meant for going to Goloka, then certainly you will achieve that place. So Jaimini is confident that the disciple has fulfilled his goal in life. He has heard the glories of Goloka. And he's fulfilled his own goal by having recited them.
And he's fulfilled his own goal by having recited them. 也实现了他的目标。
So the fruit of hearing and chanting this story have been definitely assured.
聆听以及唱诵这个故事的吉祥的成果，由此就得到了完全的保障。
So we offer obeisances to the Supreme Lord, the Son of the King of the Cowherds.
我们向那位牧牛郎的国王的儿子以虔敬的顶拜。
The King of the Cowherds is Nanda Maharaj, so the son of the king is Lord Krishna.
牧牛郎的国王是指南的大君，而他的儿子就是主 Krishna.
And Krishna always has great compassion for his servants.
主 Krishna 对他的仆人总是心怀怜悯。
And Krishna inspires his servants to develop more devotion for him.
主 Krishna 鼓励他的仆人们发展对他更多的奉爱之情。
And in this way, the servants of Lord Krishna, they become fully satisfied.
这样主 Krishna 的仆人就能够变得完全彻底心满意足了。
Just like his devotees were being very, just as if the devotees were being very kind to Krishna.
就正如主 Krishna 的奉献者们对主 Krishna 总是非常的友善。
So we should understand that this, we're coming to the end of this story.So Jaimini Rishi is remembering the supreme kindness of Krishna.
我们现在应当明白，我们的这段描述，这个故事已经来到了尾声。Sri Jaimini 他现在在意念着至尊的守神他的至尊的善意。
So he wants to offer.Everything to the feet of, he wants to offer everything to the lotus feet of Krishna. He wants to offer this effort which he made to tell this whole narration, he wants to offer it to the lotus feet of Lord Krishna. He wants to offer
everything to the feet of Krishna.
Lord Krishna is full of many different kinds of causeless compassion. But Krishna, without any selfish motive, is always keen.To do something for the benefit of others.
Krishna 没有任何自私的动机，他总是热切的渴望来为其他的众生，谋福祉。
So when Jaimini called Krishna the son of the king of the cowherds, he was doing it out of great respect for Krishna.
当 Jaimini 称呼主 Krishna 是牧牛郎的国王的儿子的时候，他是出于巨大的尊敬之情。
Or we could say he was also calling Krishna like addressing Krishna like that due to his shyness.
换言之，我们也可以说他这样称呼主 Krishna 是出于他的羞涩之情。
Because Jaimini now, Jaimini is also in the mood of the gopis. So he's shy to mention Nanda Maharaj.
现在 Jamini 已经分享了 Gopi 们的心绪，所以他很难为情来提到 Nanda Maharaj 的名字。
Because Nanda Maharaj is a senior man, he's an elderly man, he's respectable, everyone respects him. So Jamini, in the mood of the Gopis, he feels shy to mention his name.
因为 Nanda 大清是长者长辈，也是令人尊敬的，值得人们尊敬的。所以 Jamini 他现在，因为他已经分享了高品们的心态，所以他就很难为情来提到他的名字。
We should know Lord Krishna is the best of all spiritual instructors.
要知道 ，Krishna 是所有灵性教诲者的，是灵性教诲者当中的佼佼者。
So in Krishna instructs us in two ways. One way is the super soul, internally as the super soul, and externally as the Vaishnava spiritual master.
主 Krishna 以两种方式教导我们，内在的他作为超灵教导我们，而外在的他作为一位 Vaishnava 灵性导师来教导我们。
Yeah. He gives us knowledge.And everything else we require to advance in devotional service.
他赐予我们知识，以及赐予我们所需要的一切，以便我们在奉爱之途上取得进步。
Uddhava describes in the Srimad Bhagavatam about this.
Uddhava 在圣顶摩迦瓦坛就提及了这一点。
He says, Uddhava says that transcendental poets and experts in spiritual science would not be able to express their indebtedness to Krishna.
Uddhava 说，超然的诗人以及在灵性科学方面的专家们。都不能彻底地表达他对您的亏欠之情。
Even if they were given a very long life of Brahma, they wouldn't have enough time to fully express their gratitude to Krishna.
即便他们拥有像主 Brahma 那样长寿的一生，也无法完全表达他们对您的亏欠之情。
And then Uddhava says, he said about Krishna, he said, Lord Krishna appears in two features, externally as the Acharya and internally as the Super Soul.
接下来 Uddhava 又继续说，您以两种特征显现，外在的作为 Acharya 显现，而内在的作为超灵显现。
And his purpose is to deliver the embodied living entities by directing them how to come to Krishna.
他通过来指导生物如何达到 Krishna, 以这种方式来拯救体困的生物。
So whatever Jaimini spoke to Janmanjaya has been inspired by Krishna.
Jaimini 对 Janmanjaya 所讲述的一切都是主 Krishna 受到主 Krishna 的激励而讲述的。
Either he was inspired directly or on the strength of the instructions.Imparted by Krishna's representative.
他或者是直接的受到激励，或者是由于主 Krishna 的代表所传授给他的力量，教诲的力量而讲述这段话。
The spiritual teacher is considered the representative of Lord Krishna.
灵性老师被认为是主 Krishna 的代表。
So it's quite appropriate for Jaimini to offer the fruit of all of his work in presenting this narration. He's offering it all to Krishna.
对 Jaimini 而言，他把他所有这番努力的结果献给主 Krishna， 这是十分恰当的。
Because Lord Krishna is the supreme soul.
因为主 Krishna 是至高无上的灵魂。
And Krishna is the most compassionate friend of all living beings.
他还是所有众生最有怜悯心的朋友。
And he's the original spiritual master.
他是原初的灵性导师。
So, without considering spiritual qualification or ability, Krishna tries to engage everyone in devotional service to him.
Krishna, 不考虑灵性的资格或者是灵性的能力，他试图让每个人都从事对他的奉爱服务。
He tries to engage all the senses of everyone in devotional practices.
他努力地让所有生物的感官都从事于灵修。
Tries to get people to begin to chant, and to first of all to hear, and then to chant the glories of Krishna.
努力地 让每一个人从事于以聆听开始的灵修，继而又唱诵他的荣耀。
And when Krishna sees somebody, when he sees someone respond, and he sees some conditioned soul respond, then Krishna becomes very pleased.
当主 Krishna看到某人做出了反应，他就变得极其的满意。
And Krishna will shower all of his mercy on that person.
他就把他所有的仁慈洒向那个人。
Because he sees this is a candidate, somebody wants to become his servant. So Krishna was so happy.
因为他看到了这个候选人，他试图在做服务，所以他非常的满意。
And it not only is Krishna happy, but the person who is doing it, who has started to chant, he also becomes very happy and very grateful.
不仅仅是 Krishna 感到满意，而那个试图做出服务的人，他也变得十分满意。
He's very, very, very grateful to Krishna.
他对 Krishna 满怀着感激之情。
And Krishna is grateful to him that he's coming to his service.
Krishna 对这个人也充满了感激之情，因为他现在来接近他，为他做服务。
Just like ordinary people, common people are satisfied when someone helps them.
就好像一个普通人，他得到了某人的帮助，他会感激他。
So all of Krishna's devotees are always thankful to Krishna.
Krishna 的所有奉献者都对主 Krishna 充满感激。
And when Krishna sees his devotees doing devotional service, he considers them to be his most gracious benefactors, that they're giving they're being very kind to Krishna.
当 Krishna 看到他的奉献者们都在从事着奉爱服务的时候，他认为这些人是他最伟大的祝愿者，是他最好的祝福者。
Somebody's your benefactor. It means they give, you know, they support you and they're helping you in everything you do.
一位祝福者的意思就是说，他会支持你所做的一切，他会帮助你做一切。
So Sanatana Goswami has finished his commentary on the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, and now he's offering a prayer.
就此 Sanatana Goswami 经结束了他对《大伯加瓦唐甘露》一书的评论，现在他向读者给予读者祝福。
So he prays, May the Supreme Lord in the form of Lord Chaitanya, may he be always pleased.
他的祝福是，愿至尊主以Sri Chaitanya的形象总是感到满意。
He said, Lord Chaitanya personally told Sanatana Goswami to take up this work of writing. So Sanatana Goswami prays that Lord Chaitanya will be pleased with what he has written.
因为是 Sri Chaitanya 亲自命令了 Sri Sanatana Goswami 从事这个工作，所以 Sanatana Goswami 祈祷说愿 Sri Chaitanya 总是感到满意。
So the Lord's name, the Lord whose name is Chaitanya, the Lord, Lord Chaitanya, the Lord who is known as Chaitanya.Is the possessor of all divine opulences.
以 Chaitanya 而著称的主是一切神圣富裕的拥有者。
He is Lord Krishna himself, appearing as the son of Satchitmata.
他就是主 Krishna 本人，他显现为 Satchitmata 的儿子。
Or you can say Lord Lord Sanatana Goswami describes himself as the most fortunate servant of Lord Chaitanya.
Sanatana Goswami 描述自己是 Chaitanya 最幸运的仆人。
Oh no, Rupa Goswami is the most fortunate servant of Lord Chaitanya.
Rupa Goswami 是 Chaitanya 最幸运的仆人了。
Rupa Goswami is described that one is called Bhagavan who knows the future and fortune, the birth and rebirth, the ignorance and the enlightenment of all beings.
一个了解未来、了解所有命运的人，了解生与死，了解愚昧，了解起名的人，他被称为是巴格万。
So both the Lord and the best of the Vaishnavas, both to the Lord and to the best of the Vaishnavas, Rupa Goswami.Sanatana Goswami offers his obeisances.
Srila Sanatana Goswami 向主也向最优秀的 Vaishnava Srila Rupa Goswami 致以他虔敬的顶礼。
Rupa Goswami is actually the younger brother of Sanatana Goswami.
Rupa Goswami 事实上是 Sanatana Goswami 的弟弟。
But Sanatana Goswami respects him also, like a a senior Vaishnava, he sees him like his spiritual teacher also.
但是 Sanatana Goswami 是 Rupa Goswami 为年长的 Vaishnava， 也是 Rupa Goswami 为一位老师。
So this is the end of the 7th chapter of part 2 of Sanatana Goswami's Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
就此我们结束了Sanatana Goswami 所著写的
This 7th chapter was called The Bliss of the Worlds.
第七章的标题是世界的极乐。
Alright, so we have completed this section of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. This is the second part.
就此我们已经结束了大伯加瓦堂甘露一书的第二部分的描述。So
we're going to go back and we'll do the first part because we never did the first part.
在其后在以后的讲课我们就会来讲述大伯加瓦堂甘露的第一部分因为我们还没有讲述。
So this is about, part one is about the essence of Lord Krishna's mercy.
第二部分的内容是有关于主Krishna仁慈的精华。
So it begins by Sanatana Goswami describing, he says, first of all, he's offered all glories to the inconceivable Lord.
首先，Sanatana Goswami他向主不可思议的荣耀顶礼。He
came to the Lord comes to this world to give the gift of perfect love for him.
主降临这个世界，给予世人的礼物是对他自己的完美无瑕的爱。And
he's an ocean filled with many kinds of sweetness.
主 Krishna 是一个充满各式各样的甜美之情的海洋。And
he always has the fragrance of fresh youth.
主 Krishna 他总是散发着永恒长新的青春年少的芬芳。In
his form as Lord Chaitanya, he has realized the highest extent of transcendental love.
以主柴丹尼亚的形象，他能够觉悟到超然的爱的最高层面的极致。That
means the love which is eternally in the hearts of the gopis.
那就意味着永恒的住在勾皮们心中的爱。So
the purpose of this book, Brihad Bhagavatamrita, is to describe pure devotional service to the Supreme Lord.
日部大伯加瓦堂甘露一书的要旨是形容对尊主的纯粹的奉爱服务。The
Supreme Lord gives material enjoyment and liberation.
至尊主既可以给予物质享乐，也可以给予解脱。But
if somebody has bhakti, he relishes the happiness which is far greater than any happiness of liberation.
谁要是内心拥有巴提的话，他就痛爱，他就能够品尝到超越解脱带来的快乐。The
happiness of material enjoyment is insignificant compared to liberation But the happiness of liberation is insignificant compared to pure devotional service.
因其解脱而言，物质享乐带来的快，物质享受的快乐是微不足道的。但比起纯粹的奉献服务，解脱带来的快乐又是微不足道的。
So the type of devotion which is described here focuses on the lotus feet of Lord Krishna.
在这里所描述的奉爱服务是专注于主 Krishna 的奉莲花组。
Lord Krishna is the master of the gopis of Braja, Vrindavan.
主 Krishna 是Raja Vrindavan 的牧牛姑娘的主人。
So this devotion is very pure and not just ordinary love, but it's a special kind that follows the mood of the residents of Vrindavan.
这份奉爱是纯粹的无瑕的。它是追随 Vrindavan 的居民的心绪所发展出的奉爱。
So, that we call it in Sanskrit, we call that pure love prema, and that love, the perfection of that love, means you have no interest in anything except Krishna.
在梵文这种爱被称为 prema， 它是完美的，因为它是除了 Krishna 之外，它对任何事物都不感兴趣。
Just like we just read the last chapter of the book, so in that last chapter of the book, it told about how the devotees worship Lord Krishna with pure love and devotion.
我们刚刚的。就读完了本书的最后一章，在这一章就描述了对主 Krishna 的纯洁无瑕的奉爱。
And it described how these devotees they achieved the highest position, highest possible. They got the greatest success.
他描述了这些奉献者们可能达到的地位，可能取得的最伟大的成就。
They live forever in Goloka, far above Vaikuntha.
他们永恒地居住在远远超越于Vaikuntha之上的 Goloka.
Vaikuntha is the official kingdom of God.
Vaikuntha 无忧星宿是神的官方王国，正式的王国。
But Goloka is the confidential supreme abode of Krishna.
而 Goloka 是主 Krishna 机密的至尊的居所。
So in Goloka, they enjoy the company of Lord Krishna.
在 Goloka 上面的居民们享受着真主 Krishna 为伴的快乐。
So in this book, Sanatana Goswami fully describes all these concepts.
Srila Sanatana Goswami 在这部书籍当中就全面地描述了这些概念。
But he's beginning the book, so first of all, he wants to invoke auspiciousness.
在他开始这部书籍之前，他首先是召唤了吉祥。
And there will be 9 other verses which are also is like introduction to the book.
除此之外，还有其他九个诗节是本书的介绍。
In this way, he is begging Lord Krishna for his special mercy.
Sanatana Goswami 以这种方式就祈求恳求主 Krishna 的特殊仁慈。
He praises Krishna's supreme greatness.
他赞扬了主 Krishna 至高无上的伟大。
he describes that Krishna's above everyone else, is more worshipable than everyone else. Sometimes when we glorify people, we'll say Jai, Jai, and we'll use it just to glorify ordinary people.
有的时候，当我们荣耀一个人的时候，会说"斋斋呀"。我们用这种方式来荣耀一个普通人。Just
any, it could be anybody, and it doesn't matter what they do. We just may say, "Oh, Jai, he did very good. Oh, Jai, very nice."
这可以适用于任何普通的人。当我们称赞他的时候，就会说"斋斋，太棒了，太棒了"。But
here, when Sanatana Goswami says "Jai," it's to describe the excellence of the most, in the highest sense, the limit of perfection.
然而，当Sanatana的Goswami在这里使用"jaya"这个词语的时候，他形容的是完美的极致，完美的最高层面，卓越的极限。
In the Lord Krishna gives devotion for his own lotus feet. Krishna is giving devotion to his own lotus feet. And Krishna does this by revealing his beauty and his personal qualities to the and his pastimes to the devotees.
Krishna 向奉献者揭示了他自己的美丽，他的个人品质，以及他的消失光。
So the devotion Krishna gives is mixed with that pure prema, with that highest taste of love.
就 Krishna 的奉爱。 就混合了纯粹的 prema, 混合了最高滋味的爱的滋味。
That kind of love is meant for the most elevated souls.
那这种爱是针对那些最崇高的灵魂的。
But Krishna gives it to the most fallen and wretched people.
但是主 Krishna 把这份爱给予了最堕落、最可怜、悲惨的人们。
So who is this most generous Lord? Who is he that he can never be properly described?
那么这位最慷慨大度的主是谁呢？ 这位难以完全形容的慷慨的主又是谁呢？
He is an ocean, an unlimited ocean of all kinds of attractive features.
他是一个拥有着无限的、无穷无尽的吸引人的特征的海洋。
He has great beauty and very special character.
他拥有着美丽，还拥有特殊的品质。
His everything about him is so without limit. It's all every it's and it's eternal. It's not just for a little while. It's eternally he displays all these qualities.
有关他的一切都是无极无限的。 而且是永恒长存的，而不是只是短暂的停留一会儿。So
Sanatana Goswami describes how Lord Krishna he has the fragrance of youth.
Sanatana Goswami 形容主 Krishna 是拥有着青春的芬芳。
He has a special presence, just like the scent of a flower.
他的存在，他的临在。 是独一无二的，就像一朵芬芳的鲜花。
Even when he was a little baby and as a child, he showed the perfect beauty of full-blown youth.
即便他仍然是一个小婴儿、小孩子的形象，他也能够展示出完美的青春的美貌。
It was described by Lord Kapiladev where he's speaking to Devahuti, his mother. He described, the Lord is eternally very beautiful and he is worshipable by all the inhabitants of every planet.
卡比拉德对他的母亲形容说：“至尊主，他是永恒美丽的，他值得一切星球上的居民们崇拜。”
He's ever youthful, and he's always eager to give his blessings upon his devotees.
他是永恒青春年少的，总是渴望向他的奉献者们祝福他的奉献者。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
那我们今天的正课就，我们今天就讲到这里。
Are there any questions?
哎，Krishna，啊，Krishna Kumari的问题。
明白，
孤儒，请问我们服务新人是应该随顺他的喜好呢，还是应该适当接引，提升品味？我声音可以吗？嗯，可以。比如受邀请办少年生日会的活动，是应该和他的唱诵和。 生日相关的灵性知识都要有一点为好，还是我们想当然地认为孩子们都不会有兴趣听，而不提一点灵性的知识，就只是招待他们像物质主义者一样过生日，把普沙达和唱诵当成感官享受？请问孤儒，我们应该怎么接引新人 ？Hare Krishna。
Yeah。
So Krishna Kumari asked, what's the best way to serve the neophytes? Should we serve the neophyte according to their inclination, or should we also elevate them in the spiritual sense? For example, somebody invited us to have a party for the children, a birthday party for the children. Should we have the program of prasadam chanting and also some spiritual knowledge, or should we take it for granted that these children have no interest in the spiritual in this spiritual life, and we should treat them like ordinary materialists.
We definitely want to try to encourage the children in their spiritual practice. If you want to give party, then you have to try to make it Krishna conscious. Yeah.
给他们开生日会的话, 都是应该以 Krishna 直觉的方式来开。
嗯。You can do things like have a quiz, ask, see if they can chant, if they know the mantra.
比如说可以给他们做 猜谜游戏，或者是拼字游戏，或者是问问他们会不会唱诵曼陀罗。
If they can chant, if you can get them to chant and do kirtan, that's very good.
如果能让这些孩子们也开始能够念诵唱诵主的圣名，或者是跟着一起 kirtan, 那是很好的。
Of course, sometimes children, they don't appreciate what the adults do.
有的时候孩子们他们就是对于成年人大人们做的事儿不感兴趣，也不欣赏。
They think, oh, this is just for the adults. This is just for the older people. This is not for us.
他们认为这些事情就是那些成年人大人或者上个岁数的人做的，而不是我们这些年轻人应该做的事。
So you have to try somehow to get them involved, to bring them to Krishna consciousness.
所以你们就想想办法，努力的让这些孩子们也来参与到 Krishna 直觉的活动当中。The next one?
Yeah.
下一个是 Yuna, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and their devotees. How do we explain to materialists the process of gaining knowledge through Shabda Pranama?
Huh?
Because they are...
The process of gaining knowledge through what?
Shabda, Yuna Maharaji, Shabda Pranam, 应该是 Pranam 吧 Shabda, because they are used to receive knowledge through their imperfect senses and they understand Shabda as a blind face and
Shabda Praman should be.
Praman.
Praman. Shabda Praman.
Praman.
Or Shabda Brahman.
Brahman.
It could be Shabda Brahman. Anyway, sound. Shabda, sound. Transcendental sound.So how do we get the materialist to accept Shabda Praman? Huh?
Yes.
How do we get them to accept that this is infallible knowledge?
She means how can we let those materialists to accept knowledge through the process of Shabda Praman?Praman. 来翻译一下，Yuna的问题是，我们怎么向物质主义者解释，我们是通过因证的方式来获得知识的，因为物质主义者习惯于通过不完美的感官来接受知识，他们以为就是通过这超然的因证来接受知识是盲目的信仰，以及是狂热主义。
Well, we give the example, just like you want to know who is your father. So you can go to all the men and ask them, are you my father? Are you my father? You go around all the men. You can spend a long time to go to all the men and ask them, and you may never find out your father. But if you go to your mother can immediately tell you who is your father.
我们可以举这个例子，就倘若你想一个人想要知道他的父亲，他可以到每个男子面前向他询问，您是我的父亲吗？ 又换另外一个男子，他可以这样问遍每一个男子，他可以这样一段很长时间都找不到答案。另一方面，如果他来到他的母亲面前询问他的父亲，他的母亲会立即告诉他的父亲是谁。
So the same way, Shabda Praman means to accept the authority of from the transcendental sound, hearing from the scriptures and from the spiritual teachers. We accept that as being authoritative, like a mother. They can tell us everything about the Father. So people have to have that faith to accept the authority. Just like, when you ask your mother who is your father, you believe her. In the same way, you have to have faith in hearing the scriptures and hearing the spiritual teachers. If you don't have that faith, then we can't help you. You're not a candidate for devotional service. Then it's a waste of time to speak to people who won't accept authority.
人们应该对权威有信心，就像人们应该对他们的母亲有信心一样。他们应该相信经典，相信老师。如果他们没有信心的话，我们也拿他们没办法。这样他们就是没有资格来接受奉献服务。对他们讲话是浪费时间，因为他们根本不接受权威。
So some people, you can waste a lot of time.But if people don't have faith, not willing to hear, they're not candidates. You have to purify them some other way. Maybe you can give them prasadam. Maybe they can hear the kirtan.
就是跟那些没信心的人说话是浪费时间，因为他们根本不想听，他们并不是做奉爱服务的候选人。你必须以别的方式来净化他们，比如说给他们普沙的，或者让他们聆听 Kirtan。
So you want to teach somebody, they have to be willing to accept you as a teacher. If they don't accept you as a teacher, then how can you teach them?
你想教一个人，他必须把你接受为老师。如果他不接受你为老师，你又怎么能教导他呢？
Okay.
Raja Rani Dandasi. 顶拜 Guru 辈的莲花族，顶拜所有的奉献者。如果一个人通过占星，这个占星师说他这一世回不了灵性世界。如果相信了的话，因为占星受影响，会出现什么后果？
如果因为占星受影，什么意思呢？我有点不明白。
这个是 Brajarani，
他
是你说
被他的话语影响吧？
哦 ，OK。Brajarani said that if someone through astrology, one astrology said to a person that in this lifetime he cannot go back to the spiritual world, and if one believe in the words of the astrologer, and influenced by the words of the astrologer, what will be the sequence of that?
What will be the
What will be the result and sequence?
What will be the result of? Well, I don't know, maybe it means you're not putting much faith, you're not, you, it means you have more faith in astrology than in the faith of Krishna.
那么这就意味着你对占星师的信心要比对Krishna还有信心。
Astrology can only give some indications, it's not 100%. So if you put so much faith in astrology, then it's not going to help you, and it's going to restrict your devotional service.
那么这一点就会限制住你奉献服务。
We have to understand devotional service is transcendental, but astrology is dealing with the material world.
要确信的一点是，奉爱服务是超然的层面，而占星呢，它只是涉及物质世界。
So if you're really serious about devotional service and you really want to go back to Godhead, you can go back in this lifetime.
如果你真的对奉献服务认认真真的，如果你真的想要这一世，if she really serious about devotional service and really want to go back, she can go back, right?
Yes.
就是说，如果您特别对奉献服务是十分的认真，而且您这一生是特别特别渴望回去的话。
Yeah, you just have to have that faith. If you have full faith in the process of devotional service, then certainly in this lifetime you can go back. So you don't need to listen to the astrologers. If you have that full faith in devotional service.
如果您对于奉献服务充满信心，您不需要去听那些占星师的话。
So you have to be convinced about the power of devotional service.
所以关键就是 你自己要对于奉献服务充满信心，要相信奉献服务的力量。
You don't have to don't just do everything the astrologer says. Then you'll stay in the material world.
完全按照占星师的话去做的话，那就只能还是留在物质世界了。嗯哼。OK。好的。罗帕迪马大吉的问题，亲爱的古尔迪瓦，请接受我卑微的礼拜。我这几天派了10本国家放歌给我之前的同学或老师，他们都是主动布施请的书。 也有个考了研究生又考了公务员的同学，很不喜欢接受，引发了我的思考。中国很多孩子从小就灌输的价值观是知识改变命运，我以前也是这种价值观，努力考大学想改变命运，但我现在知道 Krishna 真正改变了我的生死轮回的命运。我的问题是，今生今世我们选择奉爱之徒以后， 是混杂前世的业报和 Krishna 的仁慈吗？我怎么能更深地理解改变命运这个问题，来帮助他人呢？ Krishna，
这个混杂前世的业报和 Krishna 的仁慈怎么理解？应该是就是一半是业报，一半是仁慈吧。所以我们选择了奉爱。
对，他说有仁慈的一部分，有业报的一部分，有前程活动的一部分。
OK。So Draupadi Mataji has distributed 10 Bhagavad Gita to her former student, a former teacher and classmates. They volunteered to buy the books. But one classmate who has will go to postgraduate study and also has attained an post position of public service, public officer service, didn't like to accept Bhagavad Gita. So, therefore, I have some thoughts about this phenomenon, because in China, children from their very birth, childhood, they have been taught the idea, the value. They have been taught the idea that knowledge changed their destiny. I myself is also that idea. But now I know Krishna can truly change my destiny of birth and death, samsara. My question is that in this very lifetime, we choose the path of devotional service. Is this due to the mercy of Krishna and also together with our previous paisas activity, the karma of our previous life?
Well, certainly Krishna's mercy is there. Krishna's mercy, of course, comes through the devotees. The devotees of Krishna, they're giving you the mercy of Krishna. The devotees, they gave you causeless mercy.
是奉献者给了您无缘的仁慈。
Devotional service doesn't really depend on karma.
奉爱服务不取决于，也不依赖于 karma， 我们的业报。
We may have done pious activities, but the karma, you know, the pious activities which we do, they attract the mercy of a devotee.
我们以前也许做过前生做过前程活动，但是我们这些前程活动是能够吸引奉献者给予我们无缘的仁慈。
The devotees see, oh, this person's doing this, they're pious, they're doing these things, so they understand this person's got a piety, so this way the devotee thinks that they will be good, will try to bring them to devotional service.
当奉献者们看到一个人，他有虔诚活动，他有功德的话，他会觉得，这会对他把他带到奉爱服务当中是有利的条件。
So it's not the karma directly which brings us to devotional service, but that karma attracts the attention of a devotee, and then the devotee wants to give their mercy.
并不是由于我们的阿尔玛业报直接的导致了我们的奉爱服务，而是我们的阿尔玛业报吸引了奉献者的注意力，使得奉献者想要给予我们仁慈。
Yeah. Okay.
She asked, how can we use the topics of changing our destiny to help others?How can we have deeper understanding about the topic of change our destiny? Use the topic
well,
to help others.
The thing, not everybody wants to change their destiny. Some people are quite happy with their destiny. You know, they feel quite satisfied. They think I'm doing well, I'm happy.
那不是每个人都想改变命运的，有的人对自己的命运还感到挺满意的，还感到很快乐，他就觉得我过得不错，我过得挺好，挺快乐的呀。
But, you know, we can, you know, some people are unhappy and they think I would like to change my destiny, yes? So, you can tell them you can have a better life.
有的人他的生活是不快乐的，他想改变自己的命运。那么你就可以告诉他，确实是有一种更好的生活。
People have to be a little willing to think about having a better life. Not some people they just don't want to change anything. They just want to live. They're just satisfied in their life as they are.
人们必须要愿意想要过一种更好的生活，但是有的人他就是不想改变，他安于现状。
And they have their eating and sleeping and mating and defending, and they're happy. That's not all they want.
他们有自己的吃睡交配防卫的生活，这就是他们的生，他们就是想要这种生活。
So they never inquire. They never want. They don't care to look further, to understand more about life. They never inquire.
他们就对于了解更深入的生活，他们就不关心。他们也从来不询问有没有更深入的生活。
So we try to give mercy to the people who are more willing to inquire about life.
但有的人就是对于这种肤浅的生活很满意，但是对于那些想要就好奇的人，他们有这种询问的倾向，我们给他们仁慈。
So we talk to people, you know, about death.You know, we know we're going to die one day. We all have to die. Where are we going to go? We should think about the future, the next life.
因此我们就可以跟人们谈论死亡这个话题。那早晚有一天人都会死了。那死了以后会去哪里呢？有没有考虑你的未来？有没有考虑你的来世呢？
So we try to get people to inquire. Why am I suffering? You see, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes four kinds of people who approach him for different reasons. Somebody is in distress, somebody is in search of wealth. These are very good candidates for devotional service.
跟那些诚恳的询问的人跟打交道，有的人呢，佛教梵歌谈到有四类人接受方爱服务：苦恼者、求财者、好奇爱问者、追求绝对真理的人。他们是做奉爱服务的合适候选人。
Okay.
下一个问题，沙提玛大姐，提问，灵拜咕噜、马哈拉贾和所有奉献者们，请问我们也可以视自己的灵性导师为 Krishna 的代表吗？称呼他为 Bhagavan。
Sati Mataji asked, can we regard our spiritual master as representative of Lord Krishna and call him Bhagavan?
No. No, no, you, but you, you can call him a servant of Bhagavan. Or the representative of Bhagavan. But we don't call him Bhagavan. That's very, very special spiritual masters. But if you have great respect, just like in the, we were reading today, Jaimini and Janmanjaya. So Janmanjaya had great respect for Jaimini, so he addressed him like that. So in a private, you know, if you're in private, but you don't want to make a generally announce like that in front of people, because it, then people will not understand. They will think, oh, he's God. And so that's very wrong. If you think the guru is God, he's not God, but he's the representative of God.
Janamejaya called Jaimini Bhagavan, right?
Yeah.
Janamejaya, he called his leader Jaimini Bhagavan. So in our secretly, we can just do this. But we cannot publicly tell people that our leader is, call our leader as direct Bhagavan. But people will not understand. 领导是巴万是神，这领导是不是神，所以是错误的。领导是神的代表。
无人的问题。顶拜guru翻译和所有奉献者，请问guru，只有朋友关系和父母关系，才有bhakta-vatsala关系吗？ 有点糊涂， Bhishma 与主打仗是 Vatsala 等。I
think this devotee is not familiar with the term Vatsalya. He asked,
So, the
devotee want you to clarify the term Bhakta Vatsalya. What kind of relationship rasa can be called Bhakta Vatsalya?
Bhakta Vatsala is transcendental reciprocation between the Lord and the devotee.
Bhakta Vatsala 这个词的意思是主和奉献者之间的超然的交流。
Just like the devotee gives service to Krishna, and Krishna gives service to the devotee.
奉献者们，他们服务主，然后主反过来呢，也服务了奉献者。The
devotee surrenders everything to Krishna, and Krishna takes care of the devotee.
奉献者将一切生命臣服了主，而主反过来照料了奉献者的生活。That
is Bhakta Vatsala, reciprocation based on transcendental loving service.
这被称为 Bhakta Vatsalya， 是基于超然的爱心服务层面上的交流。
Krishna says, as you surrender, I reward you accordingly.
Krishna 说，我根据一个人的臣服给予相应的回报。
So if you think of Krishna 1 hour, Krishna may think of you 1.5 hours.
如果你想 Krishna 一个小时， Krishna 可能惦记你一个半小时。
Krishna reciprocates according to how you serve him.
根据您服务 Krishna 的方式方法， Krishna 给予相应的回报。
Okay.
暂提如卡玛大姐的问题。禀拜咕噜马哈拉贾，在知觉状态好的奉献者家里做的帕萨达，和在知觉状态不好的奉献者家里做的是两回事，是因为我自己的不稳定才会这样吗？Hare Krishna。
We cook prasadam in different houses of devotee.Some devotees have good consciousness, and some devotees' consciousness is not so good. And the taste of the prasadam is different. Is this due to my instability that the prasadam will be different in those in different devotees' home?
Well, yes, prasadam will be different in different devotees' homes. It will affect the environment, the place where you're cooking and the people who are cooking. It will affect the consciousness and will affect the prasadam.
在不同奉献者家里做 prasadam 就是会不一样，都会受到影响，就是 prasadam 会受到环境、地点以及这个人物的影响，知觉也会影响普沙的。
Some devotees are very conscientious, very devotional, and so you get good quality prasadam.
有的奉献者呢，就是特别敏感，然后他特别有昏暗。他做出来的 prasadam 就是优质的 prasadam。
They'll make great efforts to prepare nice prasadam。
他们会使劲的，非常努力的来准备 prasadam。
And other people, they won't be much interested. They don't take it so seriously, and they just think, oh yeah, yeah, and it's more of a problem for them. It's trouble for them, and so then the prasadam won't be so good.
有的奉献者就对菩萨们特别的认真，他们就特别有兴趣做菩萨的，而另一些人呢，他们觉得做菩萨的很麻烦啊，有各种各样的问题啊，这样子做出来菩萨的就不会很好。
OK。
没有其他问题了。
没有其他的问题哈。
Hare Krishna。Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj。
Hare Krishna。
是这样的，我想就是就Krishna Kumari Madaji提的那个问题，我得进一步问一下，就是关于那个孩子的生日会的这个活动问题，就是我们在做这个活动的时候就。只给孩子们唱诵，带着他们唱诵跳舞，然后荣耀菩萨的，然后还就是带他们做了一些游戏啊，带他们做小饼干呀什么之类的。然后Krishna Kumari Madaji的意思就是我们应该适当的给他们讲一些哲学，讲一些小的这种课程。然后因为 可能和奉献者之间我们意见不是特别统一，所以他询问了这样一个问题，所以我们也想得到咕噜的指导，以后我们有这样活动的时候应该怎么做。
Well, you have to consider the children. How much, you know, who are they? Are they the children of devotees? Is their mother, is their father a devotee? Are they coming from a devotional background? And they're not. But then you have to see how cooperative are they in getting to do things which you tell them. Some children can be very cooperative and other children can be very difficult to cooperate, to get them to do things. So sometimes you have to consider what is actually the right thing to do. Maybe it's good to get them to help cooking, you know, get them to help cut the vegetables or to make samosa, fold the samosa or something. Teach them to do something which can be fun for them. Or maybe you have a birthday cake and you put some icing on the cake and you can do some, you know, icing, you can play, you have a, you know, let them play putting the icing on the cake. They can write something, someone's name or something, put some nice sign on the cake. Get them to do things which will be fun. You have to think.
就是说让这些孩子做他们喜欢做的觉得有趣的事儿，比如说啊，就是生日蛋糕上有那个有那外面的那层奶油啊，或者有一些点缀啊，或有一些标记啊，或者写名字啊，就是让他们就是帮做这个他们自己觉得很好玩的事儿。
Maybe they can make biscuits, you know, they get them to make biscuits and make different shapes of biscuits. Yeah, it's a real challenge to engage children. You know, you have to really have some initiative, and maybe you can get them to do a drama or do a play. You get them to do a play about the five senses, you know, in the mind. One person's the mind and one's the tongue and one's the, you know, get them to do these, some kind of drama about that, about Krishna conscious philosophy. And you can get someone to do, you want them to represent different characteristics, and you give them a piece of paper with something on it, and one paper says lust, and another paper says anger, and another paper says greed. So each of the three have got pieces of paper with this one word on it, and they have to show this and get the other people to guess what they're doing, what it is.
你可以让三个孩子分别代表三个不同品质，一个代表色欲，另外一个孩子代表愤怒，还有一个孩子代表贪婪，让三个孩子来来表演，让其他的观众来猜他们演的是哪一个品质。
Yeah, they don't speak, they just mime, and they just make faces and do things, and they have to show, get the message across to others what they're representing.
这些孩子他们不说话，他们只是在那里做鬼脸，或者是他们来做一些动作，让来传递他们要表达的信息，让观众来猜。
So you have to use your imagination and think how to engage these children to make it, to get them, you know, that they're using their brain, but at the same time, they're not getting too much into Maya, some Krishna consciousness.
所以叫开动孩子的想象力，让孩子呢，不要就是陷在 Maya 假幻象当中，让他们得到Krishna 之觉。
Understand?
Yes, yes, Guru Maharaj. Thank you very much.
Yes, it's not easy to engage children. It's a real challenge for us. But it's very important.
所以，教育孩子不是那么容易的事情，对我们来说确实是个挑战。但与此同时呢，教育孩子又是非常重要的。
And you can do things like get them to do yoga. You know, somebody's a yoga, maybe a yoga teacher, and you can get the children to try to do some yoga.
也可以让孩子做一点瑜伽练习。如果奉献者里有瑜伽老师，就可以让孩子们跟着练点瑜伽。
And you can tell stories like that and get different children to play the different parts in the story.Maybe you're telling the story about some yogi.
您可以讲故事，然后等您讲完故事呢，就让孩子们来演戏，把这个故事来演绎出来。您可以讲一个瑜伽师的故事。
So one of the children, you want them to be the yogi. Tell them.
你就让一个孩子来扮演瑜伽师。
Yeah, the other child said, has to be it can be the demon.
另外一个孩子扮演一个恶魔。
No, you can tell the story about.The young boy who died, and the man went to take bath in the morning. And when he went to take bath in the morning, he touched the dead body, the body of the boy. The boy's dead body was floating on the river. And he touched the boy's dead body, and the boy came back to life.
有一个故事讲的是有一个男孩子，他很早就夭折了，然后还有一个应该是奉献者。然后他就第二天早上去河里沐浴，然后这个孩子的死尸呢，这个男孩子的死尸就一下撞到了他的身上，然后这个奉献者呢，就使得这个孩子又起死不生的故事。
So when he came back to life, he was the person who touched him became his guru, but His family found out, his family wanted to take him home. But he said, no, he said, you already put, well, I already left you. You said, you put me on the river. You thought I was dead. So I said, I'll just stay with my guru now.
那个就是让这个男孩子 起死复生的就是他的孤乳。等这个孩子起死复生之后呢，他以前的生前的家人就过来来认领他了，但是这个孩子就拒绝了，说你们已经都离开我了，把我抛到河里，而且认为我已经死去了，那现在呢，我属于我的生命属于我的孤乳了。
I tell the story about Ajamila, the old man dying and the Yamadutta is coming to take him to Yamaraj.
或者是扮就是演阿扎米勒的戏剧，当阿扎米勒在临终的时候呢，亚玛古特阎罗王的使者就过来把他带到阎罗王那儿。
And then the Vishnu Dutas come and they say, "No, you cannot take him."
Vishnu Duta, Vishnu 的使者就也随后赶到了，就说放手，你们不能把他带走。
And so you get the children to act all these parts.
你们就让孩子扮演这个分别扮演不同的角色。
You're gonna be with children. You gotta keep them busy. You gotta give them things to do.
让跟孩子们在一起的时候呢，要让孩子们忙碌，让他们活跃。
And make it fun for them.
让孩子们感觉很有趣儿。
Okay.
Okay. 感谢古鲁队的启发，太丰富的灵性服务的食粮。顶拜您，古鲁队。
顶拜你。
下一个问题是陈芳马塔吉说：怎么证明灵性世界的存在？一听到早点回归灵性世界就感觉好可怕，当年法轮功自焚的信息就会从大脑里闪出来。
陈芳马大姐 said, yeah, how to prove that the existence of the spiritual world? Because as soon as I heard, we should go back to spiritual world early, I felt very horrible. The picture of those people who practice Falun Gong and they burn themselves, the picture popped up in my mind.
So how to prove there's a spiritual world? Well, this material world is like the reflection of the spiritual world.We see this world, we only have experience, of course, of this world, but this world is very temporary. We have to understand that.There are many things we don't know which are beyond the power of our mind and senses. There are many phenomena in this world which we don't know about, things which we don't understand.
我们不理解，还有很多现象是我们一无所知的。
So we have to we should know that there is information about a world beyond this world.
我们现在就要明白，就是有一种信息呢，就告诉我们，在这个世界之上呢，还有另外一个世界存在着。
And actually, that world is.Well, that's where the majority of people were living. We experience in this world so much misery, and there's so many difficulties, and we all have, we suffer old age, and we're all going to die. So we want to go beyond this world. We want to get out from this, all the miseries of this world. And just like people are trying to travel, you know, they spend a lot of money to try to send spaceships to go to other planets.
有的人呢，他们就坐那个太空船，我想去其他的星球去探险。
They're looking for another place to live, a better way, a better place to live.
他们在寻找有没有一个更美好的地方去生活。
So we hear about places like heaven, and we hear also about places like hell.
我们听说有一个地方称为天堂，还有的地方是地狱。
So there are, there's even on this planet some places which are like heaven and places which are like hell.
在这个星球上，我们看到有的地方呢就像天堂一样美好。
But there's also heaven on another, above this, away from this planet, on higher planets, and there's lower planets where there's hell.
那么在这个，在咱们这个星球之上呢，还存在着别的星球称为天堂，然后在这个星球之下面呢，还有别的星球被称为地狱。So
we should understand the same way, there's places far beyond heaven where there's eternal life, where there is no birth and death.
同样的，我们就这样以此类推，那么在天堂之上呢，还有永恒的生命，在那里呢是没有生死。
To actually understand the existence of the spiritual world, you first have to accept that you're not the body, that you're a soul.
为了接受灵性世界的存在，首先您就需要来觉悟到您不是您的躯体，您是永恒的灵魂。
If we're still thinking we're the body, then you'll have a hard time to understand the spiritual world.
如果我们仍然接受我们就是这具躯体的话，
那么很难来接受灵性世界的存在。So, first of all, understand that within this body there's a spiritual particle, which is the real life of the body.
首先呢，要觉悟到，在这个躯体之内呢，也存在着一个灵性的火花，灵性的粒子。这个灵性的粒子是使得整个躯体
And when the soul leaves this body, then the body is a dead body. But the soul never dies, the soul is eternal. And that soul also has a spiritual body.
而且那个灵魂，它自己也是有一具身体的。It's
not a, we have a here we have a material body, blood and bones and horrible things.
我们现在的这具物质躯体呢，是由血液、骨骼和各种各样的可怕的粘液构成的。But
the spiritual body is not blood and bones, it's bliss and knowledge eternally.
但是灵性躯体不是由血液骨骼构成的，灵性躯体的成分是永恒知识，还有极乐构成的。
But to understand these things, you first of all have to understand, you have to purify your consciousness. You have to chant Hare Krishna mantra.
但是为了明白这一切呢，首先您要净化知觉，通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 净化。
If you will chant Hare Krishna and then understand that you're not the body, that you're a soul, then you will understand more about the spiritual world.
如果通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 您明白了您不是这具躯体而是纯粹的灵魂的话，那么就可以接受永恒的灵性世界的存在了。
And you can even understand, some people even can understand this world to be the spiritual world.
而且有的人甚至他们能够觉悟到，能够明白这个世界其实也是一个灵性的世界。
We see this world also as being spiritual world because we see it in relation to Krishna, that is Krishna's energy, Krishna's planet. Everything belongs to Krishna.
在这样的人的眼里，在这样的开悟的人的眼里，那么这个世界呢，它就是一个灵性的世界，因为。它是 Krishna 的能量，它是 Krishna 的星球，它是属于 Krishna 的。
It's Krishna's because he created it. It came from him.
它属于 Krishna 的，因为它是 Krishna 创造的，它是来源于 Krishna。
We were born with nothing. We came into this world with nothing.
我们来到这个世界上是一无所有的。
So we cannot say it's mine.
我们不能声称这个世界是属我的。
Everything actually belongs to Krishna, but we're thinking it's mine. We're actually like thieves.
一切属于 Krishna, 但是我们却以为它是我们的。我们其实就是像贼一样。
We come to the world with nothing, and we will leave with nothing.
我们赤身裸体的来到这个世界上一无所有，当我们离开这个世界的时候也是一无所有的，什么也带不走就走了。
So what is yours? Nothing is actually yours.
那什么属于您呢？没有什么属于您。
You first have to understand who you are, that you're not the body, you're the soul.
首先要明白你您是谁？我是谁？这个话题，您不是这个躯体，而是灵魂。
And when you understand you're a soul, then you understand there's a spiritual world where people live as souls, where they don't take a material body.
当您明白了您是灵性的灵魂的时候，就能明白存在着一个灵性的世界。那里的人们是以灵魂的身份，他们是在那里生活在那里，他们没有一具物质的躯体。
This body is given to us as a punishment.
我们之所以获得这具躯体，我们得到这个躯体，实际上是对我们的一个惩罚。
We're punished for our pious and our sinful activities by being given a material body in the material world.
我们因为我们的前生活动和罪恶活动，我们被给予一具物质的躯壳，来在这个物质世界受苦。
So you think about this.
所以您对此加以深思。
Yes. Was that the last question?还有其他的问题吗？
还有一个问题，瑞波九瞻，顶拜 Guru 和奉献者，把经典派给没有信仰的人。如果其他人对经典没有妥善保管的话，派发者会承担业报吗？如果冒犯了经典，怎么清除？
We distribute scripture to those with this person, and if they cannot take good care of the scripture, will they take their the karma, the distributor take the karma, and how to eliminate the offense of to the scripture?
No, the devotee distributing the books won't take any karma.
不会的，太书的奉献者不承担任何业报。
He's giving mercy. He's giving the greatest opportunity. He's getting great mercy by giving people books. He will get more mercy from Krishna. Krishna will appreciate the effort of the book distributor.
他们在给予人们机会，在给予人们仁慈。通过给予仁慈，他们自己反过来也得到了仁慈。他们给人们派书，为什么非常欣赏他们的这份努力，派书的努力。
So you give the books to people, even they don't take care of it, somebody else will get it. The books travel. Somebody takes the book, he doesn't take care of it, then somebody else will get it, they will get it, they can get the mercy.
您把书派给别人，这个书他自己会旅行，然后呢，这个别人呢就会从这个没有好好照管书籍的人的手中呢拿到这个书，那么那个人呢就反过来得到了仁慈。
And how to avoid offenses against the book? Then, well, read the book. That's the best way to avoid offense against the book. Read the book.
He asked that if the others cannot take good care of the book, and is it an offense to the scripture? Now how to?
No. But if they're not devotees, then, you know, then they're not, you know, they're just karmis. So everything they do is just karma.
就如果别人没有好好照顾好我们派给他的书的话，那对我们来说不是一个冒犯，因为他们本身就不是奉献者，他们就是karmi果报工作者，他们本身就是有自己的karma业报。
And so maybe he gives a book, he leaves a book around and somebody else gets a book. Okay. Now he throws the book away, somebody else gets a book. Yeah, good.
然后比如说你把书给了这个人，然后这个书也不珍惜，然后他就随手给了另外一个人，然后或者是你给了这个 Karmi, 他随手就扔了，但是会有别的人过来捡起这本书来读，所以这也是好的。
Yeah, okay.
他又补充了一个问题，不如还有时间吗？
快一点，可以。
灵性的躯体是永恒、全知、极乐的吗？不是说只有主是全知的，我们只知晓自己吗？
So isn't that the spiritual body is eternal, blissful, and knowledge full of knowledge? Isn't that only the Lord is omniscient, all knowing? We can only know ourselves.
Yes, we can only know ourselves. I'm talking. Can you say the question again?
This devotee, because sometimes there is a saying that the spiritual soul is eternal, blissful, and
all
knowledgeable.
Yeah.
Full of knowledge. Yeah. Full of knowledge. He is confused about this term, full of knowledge.
So he wants to know about what it means to be full of knowledge.
So this devotee is confused because only the Lord is
omniscient.
I think it is a question of translation. in the Chinese, full of knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
And omniscient, it is different idea in English, but in Chinese, it is full of knowledge. It is all translated into full of knowledge.
All right, so Lord Krishna is omniscient. He knows everything because he's in everyone's heart. He's everywhere, so he knows about everything.
So Krishna, he is called as,
So, when we say living entity is a spirit soul, and the nature of the soul is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge, means knowledge means to know Krishna and our relationship with Krishna. He knows how to please Krishna and how to give service to Krishna. So this is knowledge. He knows about Krishna's energies and Krishna's pastimes. But of course, Krishna, he's everywhere, so he knows about everything and everyone. So a little difference. Yeah, we don't know everything. We're not omniscient. We're not like Krishna. But if Krishna wants us to know something, he will tell us. Okay.
又来一个问题，什么问题？还要继续吗？还是下周？可以。他说关于马达基，关于马达基和帕布那业报哪一个深？为何帕布比马达基尊贵？咕噜都是男生，没有女儿身。
The question is about is that the karma of the soul in the woman's body is worse than the soul in the male's body? Why the position of Prabhu is higher or respectful than Mataji? And also, the older gurus, they are in the male's body. No guru is in the women's body.
Well, we do have women giving instruction. We don't have women giving initiation yet, but we do have women giving instructions and giving classes. Women do give classes.
我们也有女性的就是躯体的性事咕噜，然后也有，她们不启迪，但是她们也讲课。
Yeah, we have many ladies giving classes, right?
有很也有女性讲课的。
And they're considering just now, there's a lot of discussion going on, should women also give initiation?
现在也对这个话题也有一些讨论，到底女性能不能给别人启迪
It's a little difficult though for a woman. We have to understand the woman's nature is different from a man.
我们要明白，就是女性的天性和男性不一样。
Generally, the men are there to give protection to the woman.
一般来说，男性会给予女性由着女性躯体的这个给予她是一种保护。
Women don't take sannyas.
女性她不会当托钵僧弃绝。
Because women need to, they should be protected. They should be given protection.
女性是需要得到保护的。
Then women enjoy being protected. It feels good for them.
当女性受到保护的时候，她就会有安全感，她会享受，她就不对女性来说是好的，好的。如果她受到保护，她享受这种感觉。
But just like we look at the China government, how many women do we see in the leaders of the China government?
我们可以审视一下，就是现在的就中国政府里到底有多少女性官员呢？
It's nearly all men. Why? Because the men have a more powerful, stronger nature than women.
为什么呢？为什么都是男性官员呢？因为男性他的本性就是更有力量的本性。
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Mama Jintin Jeshu.
Thank you, Mara.
Om Ganshiya Guru Mani Gevam Jantai Dufani Ganshiya Krishna Kumari Jujar Ganshiya Soyra Function Siling Ting Om Jufu Niman Chang Song Kwaila Vanshit Rui Chuan Jiao Shunli Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada Ki
Chan
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki
Chan